Oh, hi there. I didn't see you there. What if I played the run-based mode in Shadow of War? If I die, it's over.
This doesn't seem like a place you find good men!
We're not looking for good men. We're looking for mercenaries. We have no hope of taking the fortress without them.
If we make it far enough to hire them, with those things out there!
These bones! This place has swallowed things larger than us!
And smashed those bones!
They'll kill us all!
Run! Get off the sand!
It's all!
Keep calm! Keep moving!
Where?
Anywhere that isn't sand!
Sand, you say? Can't believe I already died.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Justin, I know how much you love run-based games.
I was hoping that wasn't my corpse I was dragging.
But what if the non-run-based game had a run-based mode?
What happened?
You mean like Prey?
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
They weren't as lucky as you.
Okay.
Thank you for saving me.
I'm not Chadwick Boseman, the only black man in Gondor.
Like this!
And I don't have a ring.
That little Darwin's a bit twitchy, but she should get you up to my camp, no trouble. I've got a newer one
and
myself.
And it's the dwarf guy from the first game.
Worked out all the hitches.
Hitches?
Word of advice about the climb. If you don't like heights, don't look down. And if you don't like dwarf asses, don't look up.
Yes, Boswitch Chadsman.
I did buy the boom for my mic, so if it's too loud, please tell me.
This device, you built it?
You don't need to flatter me, lad. I already snatched you from the nasties. No, what you got there is Numenor.
Ah, the ancient grappling hooks of Numenor. Of course.
Very useful.
Is that gonna be, a thing in this new Tolkien expanded universe? Just all sorts of artifacts from Numenor.
Listen, if you need a lazy contrivance for why Middle Earth would have a grappling hook, you could say it's from the High Men.
More than fair.
The High Men who built the worlds. I find the entire concept of High Men to be like shitty.
If you're moving in furniture.
You just want elves without the pointy ears.
Worms don't like heights.
Yeah.
I'm being asked, what is this bullshit? This is a video game?
So, what are you doing so far from Gondor?
Looking for the Vanishing Sons. They're a mercenary company.
Yes, I hired a few of them to look for Numenorean bits. Now I owe their leader a few mercenaries. I've got just the thing to get you to where they are. Just don't.
At least in Tolkien's case, it didn't seem like the Numenorians were like better people than anybody else.
Just run off the edge of the.
Well, I mean, you know, there's the whole thing about like how Aragorn is in his 80s.
And here, these are the places.
I mean, like ability-wise, yeah, but like as far as like. Wisdom,
on,
intelligence, personality, tendencies.
Not a bump or a scratch.
They're, you know, not really. They're not always much better than anybody else.
Oh, shit. Okay. So.
See, laddie! Nothing to it! No.
Hey, look, it's Breath of the Wild.
Yeah. My favorite game release of 2017.
Figure what out?
Will I play Fortnite or God of War next? Don't threaten me with a good time.
Just have to not think about it, is all.
Is Fortnite a good time?
It is.
I don't
know.
I've never played it.
Right.
Because you see, the great thing about Fortnite is that no one cares about actually playing it well, because it has such a big audience.
Whoa.
So you can do what we did when Deep Listens played Fortnite as a goof. Hey, what's up? How defensive would you think this place is? That's a pretty good base. Sorry. I haven't eaten yet. And just do drive-bys. Just roll around in a car, blast the radio, and do drive-bys.
Played a little bit of Apex when it came out, but I haven't played anything of the sort since.
My name is
Baranor. I played some Warzone.
I'm second captain of the Gondorian Guard at Minas.
I don't like battle royales.
Minas Ithil has fallen some time ago, I believe.
I am seeking soldiers.
Well, it's difficult to be a captain without them. Lucky for you, I've got the finest warriors in all of Middle-earth.
Yeah.
Do you carry coin of any kind?
Some.
Some. You're going to need a lot more.
So are these all mercenaries?
Yes.
What are your plans for them, eh? I assume you're not planning
to retake
Minas Ithil.
I don't think Tolkien
talked
much about mercenaries.
I'm planning to take Shindrum.
The fortress? No, 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 no. That sounds like the work for heroes. All I can offer you are mercenaries. Look, why don't you come back when you have some more money? Or sense? Morad?
How do you know that name?
You haven't changed! I remember a boy of 7. Small for his age, so he had a lot to prove. And one day, he decided that he was going to explore the caves of Umbar, but he got himself into a little bit of trouble. Lucky for him, he had a brother. A beautiful, courageous, older brother who was sent to look for him. And by the time that champion reached him, he was moments away from being devoured by Caragors.
Caragors? Jagai?
No, 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 little brother. I am Sirka now. Sirka, the unkillable. Sirka, the insufferable. Sirka, the survivor. But I still bear some scars from my former life.
How did you come to be here? Among these Easterlings?
Same old story. A village is raided, homes are looted, mothers and fathers are slaughtered, screaming tears.
This is some real theater kid shit.
Mercenaries.
How is it?
I should be thankful though, of course, eh? Not every boy gets the chance to be raised among such a merry band of killers and thieves.
But you lead them.
Yeah, only until I get a knife in my back. And believe me, that is how all leaders end up. But enough history. Blood only goes so far. You and I, we have business to transact.
Oh. Okay. So that's how it's gonna work with this. So instead of brainwashing orcs, I hire mercenaries.
Okay. Would you say the main game here is better or worse than Shadow of Mordor?
So having played the game Shadow of Mordor, I think it's frustrating.
Okay. Like,
Ooh.
How?
Because it doesn't it adds a bunch more stuff to the Nemesis system, but does not give you more interesting ways of interacting with it.
Smaller. Let's see about those outposts.
Okay, so just play the first one.
Yeah, kinda. So yeah, this is the new zone they added. The weird, awkward thing is, they add this zone in the main game if you have this DLC. But you don't need to do it. So it's just there. The 360 port of the first game should be on the Wheel of Dubious RPGs. Yeah, it should.
I mean, isn't the thing with that game that it just rips out the Nemesis system and the rest of the game is the same?
Yeah. So
then it just kind of, as a result, it becomes kind of like run of the mill.
Yeah. Anyway, so the whole thing with this mode is Baranor is a guy.
So he's not like a Norian or a Gondorian or anything?
Well, he's from Gondor, but he doesn't have a ring and he's not a wraith. So that's their justification for this having permadeath.
I don't know. That sounds... You don't need a justification for dying and loading the last checkpoint.
And that's why he has... Well, you do...
Tell me, brother.
In a game with...
What do you see?
Recurring enemies.
Orcs. Wagons. More orcs.
Sure.
Do you know what I see? Coin.
Alright, I'm going to start skipping cutscenes.
Keep an eye out for wereworms.
Aren't you interested in this brotherly rivalry?
No, I'm not.
Wereworms?
Wereworms, yes.
Tolkien is spinning in his grave so fast it's going to start taking off here in a little bit.
Why are we stopped for a bunch of globs in the rear? Because they've got the crossbow.
Okay, I got a hand crossbow. And I don't have my wraith vision either. Okay.
Hello, Borgmaster.
Okay, so Wardor here has a parachute and grappling hook?
Yes.
Yeah.
Which, why did no one tell me?
Because I'm not. Which made me. Because this isn't the main game.
What is this?
This is the DLC that is permadeath. It's a mini campaign that.
You see, I was, as soon as I saw the parachute and all that stuff, I was like, I was immediately interested, and then I remembered, you can just die permanently.
Okay. So this is, okay, so they put, like, the good stuff in the DLC.
That's yeah, in the main game, you just kind of zip around with your dumb wraith powers.
Boo.
And I got to a point where I was very much
like done with that. I mean, I don't know if I can put them on the record or not as saying that if a game gives you a grappling hook and parachute at the same time, then the game is automatically good.
Did Far Cry 4 get a grappling hook? I never played it.
Far Cry 4 gives you the mini chopper.
I thought I had a wingsuit though.
Oh.
Did that engine even handle a wingsuit?
Well, I'm gonna Google this. I might be totally wrong.
I well, appreciate if anyone that has he a, plays differently from Talion. They actually went to the trouble of making him play differently. Like, his abilities are not one-to-one more of the same analogs to the Wraith stuff that you have in the main game.
Okay. So there is more a wingsuit in Far Cry 3, 4, 5, New Dawn, and 6.
Yes.
I don't remember it in 3. Supplies
come through this canyon. Yes, I never get far
you get it
games,
very late in 3.
Oh, okay.
So they've been working on
this
a Wonder Woman game
since 2017.
Yeah. Yeah, they have.
Let's get these wagons back to the Oasis. Today we get paid.
Yeah, DC games not necessarily having the best track record. Stop.
No.
You and your boys need to get all this grog cleaned up.
I mean, Warner Brothers as a publisher doesn't have the best track record. Very spotty. You know, since no one played Zoop. You know, sounds ever like since no one I played need. Zoop, it's, time to it's just been up and down grog. For them. Yeah, I bet you're wondering what I'm talking about. I'm talking about Zoop, America's favorite killer of time. No one wants to engage with me on Zoop.
What's this?
I'm looking it up. I don't know what Zoop is.
It's a
Zoop and Salad.
Yes.
Zoop.
It was someone's attempt to make the next Tetris.
It's no Hattress.
It is no Hattress. You're correct. It's, like the next Tetris wouldn't come around until probably Lumines. But Warner tried in like 95 to do that. But no one played it. It's very Zoopy.
What is this a giant skull of?
Dragon.
That which dwelled in Middle Earth before the time of man.
So some kind of dragon god or something.
They call it the Ancient One.
Apparently in Necrovision, you can come across Tolkien in a prison.
Yeah, that checks out. Oh shit, what's this? Is that a Numenorean artifact? Of course!
The Numenoreans set their minds to making a man fly. But when they figured out a device that could do it, they decided they weren't impressed enough with themselves.
An artifact of old Numenor.
Yeah, the grappling
yes.
hook.
I can't wait to see what the
dwarf
does with this.
Because we all know that Numenoreans had grappling hooks.
Yeah, if they'd have had grappling hooks.
Yeah, if you pay attention to all of the songs that Aragorn and the elves sing, you would know that they had grappling hooks in the time of Numenor.
Yeah, didn't you read the appendices?
Yeah, didn't you read the Silmarillion?
I actually have read the Silmarillion. It's been a long
you
time,
have my
but I did read it.
I'm impressed. I tried to read it and I dropped off. I should go back sometime.
I don't have the patience anymore.
Okay.
Yeah, there's a lot of patience.
In the
I was
time
in college
of Mordor.
Then. I have a full-time job now.
That enemy was intersecting with the ground there quite
in
a bit.
In the time of Mordor, the ancient man of Numenor.
So, I'm not gonna give Lord of the Rings like a hard time for the fantasy tropes because that's where they came from. Like that's like the origin point of all fantasy tropes. So for them doing stuff that sounds unoriginal, it was original.
Yeah.
When Tolkien did it, there are things I wouldn't fault Lord of the Rings with, but that's not one of them.
Oh. I have to slash them to knock them over.
Well, isn't Tolkien's description
of all do you have
Numenor
to restart the entire
gay?
Thing for that one mistake?
Apparently, this does not count as far as permanent death.
Tolkien wrote plenty about the Second Age, which is all in like side books and appendices
like
and the Silmarillion
and shit
and the
that
tales.
Was not published until
a lot of that stuff.
Till's death.
Yeah, a lot of that stuff was published by his son.
Yeah, there's a lot of ancillary notes about the Second Age. If that's what you're into. But if you're going to get that obsessive with weird medieval nonsense, you might as well just do what Tolkien did and become a scholar of... Oh, I'm going to come up with a name.
Ancient languages. Beowulf.
Beowulf, yes. You might as well just become a Beowulf scholar in order to learn English. Like, if you have the attention span to delve into the depths of, like, Tolkien's lore, like, you should just go for, like, Tolkien's job of just being, like, an early medieval literature.
Yes, old nerd. English.
Yeah.
You mean a philologist?
Is that what that's called?
What do you call me?
He was a philologist. Which is like...
Wait, so there's a full Tolkien license or just a Lord of the Rings on its own license?
So, in the olden times... In the olden times, the whole thing with, with
in,
EA...
In the third age of the world.
Yes, in the third age of the world. Before the time of Mac, before the time of Warner, there was a before time, when there was a movie license and a film license.
A book license and a film license.
Yes.
Where The Hobbit on Xbox was book license. But like those EA games were film license.
They were united under a dark master. For in the land of Warner, in the fires of Mount Doom, a new license was forged. A master license. One IP to rule them all.
You mean ruin them all?
Yes, and now the Embracer Group owns some chunk of Lord of the Rings. Dune 2 Part 2 in theaters this March.
Hey man, I'm looking forward to that.
I like that Dune 1 movie. I am not a fan of the Dune 1 book.
Yeah, same. BRB.
What have you done?
Cut off the enemy's supply line.
That was also my supply line! I need to keep the coin flowing. Do you see those men back there? Those are not soldiers. Their loyalty is bought, and when they stop getting paid, their blades are no longer under my control.
These are Marauder Orcs. When we take their fortress, you'll get half their fortune, and I'll use the other half to pay you and your men for whatever comes next.
All right. You know, coin is one thing. That fortress is another. Oh, I hope you've got a great plan.
It really seems like becoming the leader of a mercenary band maybe isn't the best career choice.
No. Let's see. Let's capture an outpost. How about that? Also, to be clear, if I die, I have to play a different game with Shadow in the title.
Okay.
That's the rule for this stream.
Is it specifically going to be Shadow the Hedgehog, or are there other games that you're thinking of?
Well, it's not going to be Shadow of the Colossus.
Is it going to be Shadow of Undrentide?
One would hope, but no. I would need to reinstall... Neverwinter Nights.
I can't imagine it would take you long to install Neverwinter Nights.
Yeah, but then we have to deal with... I've said this before. I'm very done with third edition.
Oh.
I would consider playing through... Neverwinter Nights as part of a podcast, perhaps.
Hmm.
Perhaps a podcast on Neverwinter Nights.
Okay. What do you mean this man has no special powers? His knees are clearly made of steel.
No, that's just the men of the West.
Hmm.
Alright, I got the clip.
Great.
Against the meanest ethel war chiefs. Wait, so this man has no knees?
No, he has knees of steel.
Oh, okay.
He jumped off a very high spot and rolled, and he was okay. No fall damage.
I mean, that's just parkour.
Shock! Boredom can kill an orc sure as a blade. So, if you look a bit fidgety, maybe, I don't know, amuse yourselves by killing
Shock
each other.
Shock is rank 36! Okay, so we gotta capture a victory point. I also appreciate this because this means I cannot brainwash my way to victory by just brainwashing every orc I run into. Which is how I... So I'm playing this on the hard equivalent. Which is what I played the main game on. And I got to a point with the main game where I just didn't die.
So when you said you're done with, like, third edition, are you done with, like, D&D rule sets in general?
That's a yes, right?
It would take a lot.
Huh.
I mean, hey, Baldur's Gate, it's good. But specifically the 3X, 3 and 3-5 rule sets are just... Part of that is because Pathfinder exists and has the same problems, but also has more going on.
I mean, Pathfinder just turns the complexity dial up to 11 and then turns it up some more. And then Pathfinder 2, from my understanding, just does different stuff entirely.
It is differently... it is differently complex. Some of the things they do to streamline Pathfinder 2nd Edition are really good.
Yeah, I guess I never really got the all of the everything about the different versions of D&D, because I've only ever experienced it as a vehicle for bits.
Well, I'm here to help. Because I... So basically, there's not a huge difference between 1st and 2nd editions of AD&D. But it's also awkward because there's basic D&D, which is a slightly different thing.
So none of that's important unless you're going to play the original Infinity
Engine
games.
None of that matters unless you're an idiot like me who owns multiple rule books. I have the reprints of the 2nd edition rule books, like, physically. Shocked.
I feel like if you're in deep enough to play 2nd edition, you know what you're getting into.
Why would you own rule books when you could yo ho ho in a bottle of rum?
Oh shit!
Like it's not hard. You won't get this. Like, you should give those fuckers
not
money.
Even
in the first
a
place.
Little piece. And speaking of little pieces,
that's my official legal advice for everyone watching this. Don't give those fuckers money. Pirate it.
Okay.
What?
All right. I don't know. I like that those things exist. Also, I don't actually have any
tomes,
any rule books.
I have PDFs.
Yeah, I mean, I have some PDFs that were distributed to me.
He's mad now.
But if I were, for instance, running my own like campaigns, I would buy the book for IRL with IRL friends.
Oh no, I would make all those dirtbags bring a laptop and like use PDFs. I ain't buying shit.
That sounds too funky.
You're already playing D&D. That's already too funky. That's why D&D is best to get used as a vehicle for bits. What, is that too casual?
No.
Did everyone clam up at my mission?
No, sorry, I was killing Chuck the Judge.
He's busy.
He's busy.
Murdering dudes.
Okay, I can never tell who is and isn't squeamish about just downloading things.
I'm not squeamish about downloading things. My personal opinion on it, for me, is if something is reasonably available for a reasonable price, I'll go buy it. If you pirate everything you want, whatever. It's not my business.
My only advice for the young and impressionable viewers of The Arbitrary Water,
yeah,
is that piracy is the only ethical form of consumption under capitalism.
Sure. But also under capitalism, there are certain things I want to continue being made, and that involves them still making money. So I'll do my part.
Oh, I see. So that's how...
How much do you go about pirating, Borgmaster? Everything?
Well, I do have my Vita in front of me, and I think I've talked
about
that.
That's different. If it's an old video game, just fucking
whatever. Oh, okay, if it's an old video game, so what's the cutoff? 10 years? 12 years? 15 years?
The old cutoff is it reasonably available?
I mean,
like, if you want to play... Reasonably available meaning, like, if you, for instance, want to play... Halo 1, the Master Chief Collection is out there, and I would say,
do my rule of thumb is if I can get it legally for a reasonable price, I will do that.
That's what I mean by reasonably available. However, if you want to play, for instance, Wolfenstein 2009.
Pirate that shit.
Pirate
that
no,
shit.
If you want
no,
to
those
play,
developers aren't getting any money from it. Pirate it.
If you want to play a PS2 game, Sony doesn't really care about distributing that game to you again. Go pirate it.
If a piece of media is old enough, the original creators aren't getting paid jack shit for it. So pirate it.
That's right. We here at twitch.tv/arbitrarywater say, if you can't get it legally, there are other ways.
I also think that when developers engage in shitty practices, like really invasive, awful DRM, like Capcom's been doing with some of their recent output, where they've put out a DRM that really doesn't work well, then... you know, go sell the high seas.
Who's to say?
All right, Jatu's over here with some fun facts.
What's your fun fact, Jatu?
Lord of the Rings Battle for Middle Earth and its sequel never going to get a legal re-release.
Yes, there's a game in his Steam library that will never start again.
and getting me my
I also have a game in my Steam library that won't start. It's because of Uplay shenanigans.
We'll need to be discreet.
Everyone, F in the chat for Jatsu's Steam game.
What's the game, Jatsu?
Vigil, Blood, Bitterness? That's not a real game.
Uh-huh.
We've got to start. So with Mark dead, that makes Gibu the new war chief. Or is it all Baruch? How am I supposed to keep this straight?
You are having a look. Don't run away from the floor.
Make it great.
Yeah, so
like I'll say piracy is good and cool.
Mine is Splinter Cell Blacklist.
Oh, yeah,
oh, that it doesn't start anymore? Really?
The game will work if you're for me because whenever I start it tells me that my Uplay account attached to this game is not signed into. But I've only ever had one Uplay account. I've never made more than one. So I don't know. And I have played this game before.
I remember having to do some shit with my Uplay account to get Might and Magic 10 to work again.
Yeah, I think Might and Magic 10 has the same problem for me. But yeah, if I ever wanted to play either of these games again, I'd go pirate them.
Encourages competition.
Yar. You know, Jatsu, I was expecting this to be something much more anime and worth making fun of you about, but this is like some kind of artsy game. Okay.
Vigil, Blood, Bitterness. Okay, let's go look this up.
All right, Jatsu, you are spared my my mockery for now.
Disappointing.
You've lived a hard life, Jagai. I survived,
didn't I? Oh, indie bundle. Alright, makes sense.
That's better than most.
How have you survived among the Easterlings?
Well, I suppose if it was some kind of anime pervert game, you probably wouldn't have fessed up to having it. So, makes sense.
This feels like watching this feels like watching you play an Assassin's Creed game.
I mean, yeah.
This is basically Assassin's Creed Origins, but like reskinned.
Does Origins hold up?
Decently? I mean, people like that game.
I mean, no, that game's 7 years old.
Yeah, this game and Assassin's Creed Origins are contemporary.
Borgmaster dealing with the march of time here.
This game is 7 years old?
Uh-huh.
It sure is. 2017, baby.
I thought it was only like 4 years old.
No. 4 years ago,
No, 4 years ago, Doom Eternal was coming out.
Yeah.
COVID started 20 years ago. Not 20
years ago.
4 years ago. 4 years ago. I meant to say four.
It's been 20 years since COVID started.
Oh, what if I told you Nolan North is about a third of the orcs in this game?
Sure. I mean, 2017, he was in less roles, so this would have been almost novel.
And anyway, what if I told you another third of the orcs is Steve Bloom?
Good for him.
That makes sense. Wolfenstein: The New Order is 10 years old. Which
10 years old? Oh, no.
Yeah.
Done much that's right, 2014, the weakest year in video games. Taste
for exotic meats.
Yeah, but the New Order's great.
Yeah.
I can't believe that game is not consider more of a classic. It's so good.
I think most people like us have forgotten how old it is. Let's make this a fight to remember. That's why the word classic hasn't been thrown around. Oh wait, New Colossus was 2017, wasn't it?
It was either 17 or 18.
But the difference is, they've shown a video. Machine Games has now shown a video game since that. I don't count Youngblood.
Oh yeah, Indiana Jones.
I mean, Youngblood. I played all of Youngblood.
I played a good chunk of Youngblood with Joku.
I played Youngblood through to the end. Don't ask me why.
Youngblood plays fine, but I feel like those two characters, it leans too far into the goofy nonsense, and like.
Anyway, yeah, no, y'all like Batman combat? It's character action combat for people who don't want to learn complexity. And it's good.
Wow.
How do you like Batman combat, Bugmaster?
Yeah, I'm fine with it. And also, fuck you.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was too busy, being like, oh, you know, just having to learn how to do a dodge dash cancel. Why learn how to dash cancel when you can just press the Y button to counter in a rhythmic fashion?
Oh yeah, I mean, you have to be. Only babies don't want to learn how to do perfect parries 30 times in a boss fight.
Yeah. Listen, I beat DMC3 using Royal Guard, so I can tell you a thing or two about perfect parries.
I've watched Shangri-La Frontier, so I can say something about perfect parries.
Perfect parry. The only perfect parry we need is Parry the Platypus. Am I right, my fellow Zoomers?
Yes, exactly. I'm a Zoomer who grew up with that character. Absolutely.
Parry the Platypus.
That's not what he sounds like, is it?
Of course!
No, that's what Dr. Doofenshmirtz sounds like.
I disagree. Dr. Cox's first name in Scrubs is Perry, so that's the perfect Perry.
That is the perfect Perry.
I've seen two kinds of mercenary, brother. One of them fights for gold, and the other seeks death in whatever way he can find it.
R.I.P. Matthew Perry, that's what I said.
Rest in power, Matthew Perry. Well, Justin, are you gonna speak ill of the dead by not saying that he is a perfect parry?
Who?
There's no turning back.
I zoned out. Who are we talking about?
I'll be there for you,
Matthew Perry.
Who's Matthew Perry?
Ah, jeez. Never mind. I give up.
I'll be there for you. No.
No.
He's Friends. I'm guessing he's somebody from Friends.
Yes.
Listen, Friends, I don't even like Friends, and I know who Matt. You know, Matthew Perry, a star of Fallout New Vegas. He plays Benny.
Yeah, he was in Fallout New Vegas. No.
He's the guy who shoots you in the face.
Matthew Perry died recently.
I know. I've heard his name recently as someone who died.
Which is why I said rest in power earlier.
Okay.
Uh huh.
I don't know anything. I never really watched much Friends, so I don't know.
How did you get away with that?
How I feel.
What kind of 90s kid are you?
So you never had an older sibling that would watch it?
I am the older sibling.
Look at you.
I watched a lot of Cartoon Network as a kid. If it wasn't on Cartoon Network, I didn't watch any of it. For the most part.
They didn't have to share a TV with a teenager in the 90s. Can't believe it.
No, I did not. I was the teenager with a TV.
I was the teenager in the 90s.
Wow. Well, as someone who had to share a TV with a teenager in the 90s, I saw some Friends, I saw some Road Rules. Just a lot of real hot garbage.
Mm-hmm.
I'm doing a passage with Torrin.
Oh, I've heard of this.
Round.
I mean, you should get Dr. Blood.
Okay. I'm pouring it up here.
Who else is dropping in now? Okay, Geno.
The card game Geno's playing looks fun and good.
And it is fun and good.
Alright, well,
I do love a good stomping.
Ashgarn the Thunderer!
Ashgarn the Thunderer indeed.
He's highly flammable.
Just look at his face.
Ooh, Boogle got a new ability. What's Boogle? Which oh, Boogle can be a nurse. Do you got an ouchie or
hello, nurse?
You're Boogle.
So there's like three people streaming right now?
Yeah. It's fine.
Okay.
It's good and cool. I mean, if you want a fourth, I can, like, pull up some bullshit.
I mean, I'm sure I could get something running too, right. But I'm not going to.
It would be very funny.
Open
everyone.
Up this cupboard.
Everybody just commenting chaos. Over each other on their
I
own
stopped.
Stream.
Pure chaos.
I stopped my stream.
I'll get have a good
I'm
advocate.
Watching Shadow
Waddle.
Yeah. I'm gonna dip out. I will Shadow talk Waddle. To y'all later.
Bye.
This is a bottle. Oh, all right, they're candy wipes.
So, not talking to ZP, talking to everyone else. I've come to the conclusion that Japan had the right idea about adventure games. Just remove the pixel hunting and inventory bullshit, and just do the talky talk. Cause that's what you're there mm-hmm. for.
You're wrong.
Like I said, I wasn't talking to ZP when I said that. I was talking to everyone else.
Okay, welcome to Asthenia.
You're talking to the sane people.
No, you're talking to the people that don't like interactive fun.
As a
you
hater of interactive
with,
fun, this is true.
You interact with narrative adventure games?
Let's press a button. Aw, yeah! We're playing some classic adventure-y.
Yeah!
I did not realize that this game is using SCI, which is definitely a cool thing. So, that's Sierra Creative Interpreter, so this is their version of the Scum Engine, which has some certain advantages and also some disadvantages, but... I believe I saw when I looked at the command script that this is running SCI 32. So this is late era SCI. Okay, so I think that's the exit. Oh.
This Shadow of War game seems fine. Good.
Yeah, I'm playing
seems
the
like a
side
fun,
mode that
fun
has permadeath.
Okay. Oh, you know what this lava world reminds me of? It reminds me of that game that I played, Brayden, that was based off of those books by Legend Entertainment, but not the Companions of Xanth game, but
the
same studio. Deathgate, right. That game is wild.
Need execution.
Let's look at this symbol.
And he gets mad when I try to
I think the 76ers have packed it in.
Triangle bar. Okay, so is this some Mayan bullshit? Oh no! You're gonna make me do another Mayan number game puzzle?
Finally.
No. God, no. No, please no. Lord have mercy on my soul. What have I done to forsake you and be punished? I actually know that. Right? Let's go to the hut, I think. Oh, what the fuck? fuck is this?
Can't believe I get paid for that! Enough fight!
Okay, let's say that some of these backgrounds are very good for their hand painterly nature. Some of these backgrounds are a little tough to understand what I'm looking at.
Braden, yes. Is that an arm crossbow?
Yes, you know, the legendary Gondorian hand crossbow. Oh.
I don't know if you're bullshitting or not.
Didn't you read your books?
Didn't you read the appendices?
Okay.
Anyway, my bodyguard killed the guy.
It's a seesaw puzzle. Great. My favorite.
You got saved by a savior?
Yeah, my bodyguard saved me.
There was just a torso hovering. Back there.
Yeah. That's what happens to orcs when you cut them up.
All right.
Shadow of torso.
More like shadow of orso. What's orso? I don't know what orso is.
Orzo, the pasta.
Oh, that's
orzo is a pasta. Yes. It's got a Z in it.
Oh, God.
Time to hire a mercenary.
Help.
Who costs money.
What am I looking at? What is happening to me? Okay.
Roosh.
What was the point of that? Oh, it was the cannonball. I get it now. Can I do it again? I think the puzzle is click this until I can't get any more cannonballs. I just need to click to watch the same animation over and over again until it doesn't do it anymore.
Yeah, that seems lame.
Don't use that word.
That seems,
lame?
Mobility impaired.
CP, I've learned something.
Oh.
I've learned something incredible. James Johnson is still in the NBA.
Who's he playing for? Who's ISO
well,
Joe
he's
playing
on the Pacers.
For?
No, James Johnson.
Oh, James Johnson, okay. So
Bloodsport.
Man, Bloodsport's back. Do you guys not know who Bloodsport is?
Do you know why he's called Bloodsport, Brayden?
Why is he called Bloodsport? Is it because he...
He was an actual enforcer, and while he was trying to start up his NBA career, he was also doing real-life MMA.
Uh-huh.
He was doing kickboxing.
Yeah, and,
So apparently, one time at practice, someone wedged the ball between the rim and the backboard, and James Johnson jumped
one
and kicked it out.
To secure.
Uh-huh.
That sounds, cool guy shit, I suppose.
Yeah, he is, he has been on the short list of people who you least want to fight in the NBA the entire time he's been in the
NBA.
Him
and Steven Adams.
Well, Sarkar ever finds me up here.
Oh, yes.
Found something.
Steven Adams just large and from
New Zealand.
Zealand
man that, well known for just being a wall that will hurt you.
They literally just give you the Arkham City, glide catapult.
Oh, wow, really?
Huh? Yeah.
Sure.
They sure
is
do.
Is it the same developer?
I mean, they're both WB, but no, this is Monolith.
Can have loads of fun with that.
I bet they brought in the glide catapult guy for a week or two.
All right.
But yeah, Steven Adams, there's a great video of Steven Adams breaking up a
fight. Oh, this is
a
puzzle. Okay.
It's a puzzle in
this
game.
There's two large men.
Oh, okay. I have to, like, position him to where he gets the ball.
So two large men are yelling at each other, and Steven Adams wants it to stop, so he walks over to a 7-foot tall man and just picks him up. Just bear hugs him, picks him up, and walks him out of the conversation. He just walks him like a good 20 feet away from where he was arguing.
If you want, maybe
it's
one of the harshest things I've ever seen. Look up Steven Adams' screen against Pat Bev.
Welcome to the circus.
It is one of the gnarliest screens I've ever seen. And all he did was just stand in front of him while he was running. He was just like, I'm a man. Get past me. Oh, wait, you're dead.
You're quite the showman.
Too bad.
I'm watching NBA screens.
Seems the show has already begun. Steven Adams is such a threat that the only time that he's kind of lost an on-court conflict was when Draymond Green decided to kick him in the nuts. Which was the first
of
eight.
Yeah, his screen on Pat Bev was completely legal. My God.
Yeah.
Have you ever brickwalled someone?
No.
With a screen?
No.
Oh, I've done it before. In college, I got someone bad. It was, they didn't see me. They didn't know I was there. And they were running full speed.
It seems we have a special attraction in our festival of
blood. Alright, I watched just enough of 60-bit sensation to find the screenshots I was looking for.
Also, Gino, the rule is because this is the, this DLC campaign is a permadeath mode. You die for realsies.
It's kind of like Rogue.
Yeah, it is like Rogue. If I die, I will have to play a different game with Shadow in the title.
Like Shadow the Hedgehog.
Perhaps. Who's to say? Shadow of the Tomb Raider.
You know. I'm watching an NBA Hardest Screens video ZP.
Yeah.
Pat Bev gets hit with a lot of them. Pat Bev is in this montage multiple times.
I wonder why.
Oh, he set one of them. He set one of them, and it was illegal. He's in this montage three times so far. One of them was just a very illegal screen he set. Two of them were very legal screens on him.
Are you gonna also, if you're gonna play like good games with Shadow in the title, does this mean that you're gonna like start playing Sekiro?
There's Fire Emblem Echoes, Shadows of Valencia.
I bet he already has that downloaded. I bet he already has
There's Shadow Warrior. There's Spider-Man Web of Shadows. Styx Master of Shadows. Thief Deadly Shadows, I think.
I do have that installed. But then ZP will be like, ah, it's the best Thief game! Ah, Shellbridge Cradle!
Wait, Shadow Man. Is Shadow Man what I'm thinking of?
I do have Shadow Man installed.
Yeah, I should just play Shadow Man.
What about Shadow Warrior?
We
already said Shadow Warrior.
Get the program.
This one here.
I did finally beat Shadow the Hedgehog, by the way.
You beat it all 10 times?
I beat it.
Oh, you beat it
once.
Yeah,
but did you get the true ending?
Yeah.
Oh, we're not done yet.
I got an ending.
Amaze you.
Did you get the true ending? Did you get ending A?
There is no true ending.
I hate to say this, but
did you get
Shadow the Hedgehog? That Zosha. I got the ending that I felt was most appropriate for Shadow the Hedgehog. Who do you think you got
the idea is it the one where it's implied that Shadow is going to kill himself?
You mean the trouble you got me into? Thank you.
No.
That's like
no, but I do know that one.
Because that's one of the endings I got.
Shadow does do that, huh?
So when Shadow starts going, starts saying he's gonna cut his life into pieces, that this is his last resort.
He's like, the world would be better without me. And then Sonic's like, yeah, it would, Shadow.
Yeah, Shadow. Yeah, I dare you, Shadow.
Like, would never.
No, Sonic would never.
Let's get out of here.
Oh
It's not like it's too lawful good to do anything.
It's a rampage!
I feel like he's chaotic good.
Is he chaotic good? Like how much havoc and destruction does he cause?
I mean, Sonic fights against the military-industrial complex.
Make merry with your captain.
He escapes from the city.
He does escape
from the city. He rolls around at the speed of sound. He's got places to go. Follow his rainbow.
Does he?
He's got to follow his rainbow.
Does he ever fight cops for good reasons?
Yeah, he fights the military-industrial complex.
He fights Gun.
Oh, okay.
They're called Gun.
Okay, then chaotic good then. Sure.
Oh, he's back! Oh, he's a trickster! But none last long.
Yep. Okay, so it was four cannonballs to one blonde boy. We all played together. Oh,
damn it! Catapult. That song's so good.
Oh, am I gonna shoot myself in the catapult?
Brayden, why is that song so good?
Because Crash 40.
Right.
Some advice for the viewers: if you are cooking with hot peppers, don't touch yourself in the catapult for like at least a couple hours afterwards.
Hey, I've already talked about hot peppers and not touching yourself.
Welcome to twitch.tv/arbitrarywater, your number one source for
for male hygiene.
What?
Advice. What?
What? Did I get hit mid animation?
I'd love to see it.
Okay.
Well, so it's now Shadow Man time.
We could play Shadow Man. I do have Shadow Man installed.
For some reason, you have Shadow Man installed.
You know why
I'm not gonna
Shadow
ask
Man
why.
Installed.
Who would do this?
I'm not gonna ask why.
Why?
Do I have a cannonball?
I just said, not gonna ask why. There are some things
I'm
that we don't need
why.
To know.
Gino, are you aware of beloved N64 platformer based on a comic book? Shadow Man.
Oh, was that? Did they play it on Giant Bomb at one point?
Who knows?
Probably.
Welcome to Shadow
Man. For many thousands of years, the Shadow Men have protected the world of the living against threats crossing over from the spiritual plane known as Deadside, the place where everyone goes without exception when they die. Michael Lerois is the current heir to the mysteries of this ancient lineage, bearer of the Mask of Shadows. When darkness falls, he becomes the walker between the worlds, immortal voodoo warrior, taker of souls, lord of Deadside. The Shadow Man.
I am the Shadow Man.
I needed to have a cannonball in my pocket.
Is that cannonball in your pocket or just happy to see us?
I'm really happy to see my jets here.
Great. Yeah. Yes. Great.
Oh, right, this.
Shadow Man. Remember when video games were edgy? When they had edge to them?
I have to save here.
Man.
The 9th of November, 1888. But my deeds am unknown, and I am known as Jack.
That's gotta be on Spotify, right?
Jack the Ripper.
Almost certain.
By my deeds am I known.
Oh, 100%.
Truly bloody.
If not, you can find
I took them all to my heart. Marianne Nichols. Annie Chapman, Elizabeth Stride, Catherine Eddowes, Mary Kelly.
I can
truly love them all.
That's,
but the immortal power I sought within the sordid confines of their bodies, the still beating organ of the soul, was not to be found. The ritual of the knife was to no avail. I am bereft, and must therefore perform that bloody ritual upon myself.
Stay your hand, Jack, and listen to what I have to say.
How did you find this place? Who are you?
My name is Legion, for we are many. The immortal power that you seek does exist. It does indeed lie within the soul, but only within certain ones.
certain
now I have to
dark
remember.
Souls.
Dark Souls?
What are you that you can produce such things from thin air?
Really an explorer, much like yourself.
What is it that you want from me?
Try to open
you are
Spotify
an architect by trade, are you not?
I am.
Oh no.
Then I would have you build a cathedral to pain.
A cathedral
a place
to
where
pain?
You and I and others like us may join together.
Pain.
A place of asylum for all of the unique and misunderstood individuals that will follow you as the time of Armageddon approaches.
This is the
and
most
at the heart
90s
of
comic
asylum,
book.
We shall construct a great dark engine powered by souls
yep,
of
escape the city is.
And we shall harness their power
most
to create
most
an immortal army to
made.
Punish and cleanse this pathetic world.
This is
where might I build
master.
This cathedral of yours?
Across the Vale. In the darkness, amongst the restless spirits of those who have passed beyond, in the place known as Deadside.
Then, if
I mean,
I'm to join you,
to
I must die.
It is prophecy.
Deadside.
We cannot
Deadside.
Fail, for we are many.
For we are many!
Amen
okay,
to that.
Escape from the City is unironically good.
Yeah. Listen, you'll find no Crush 40 slander here.
So I actually have to, like, be careful about where I click for this guy, so is that he doesn't fall into lava? Okay.
The end is sooner than you think.
Come to mama, baby!
Hey there!
They know how to use a slap face.
The darkness coming.
What's the problem, Magneta?
I had a dream, Shadow Man. A real bad dream. A Deadside dream. The Five are here. The heralds of the apocalypse. Deacon's file confirms everything I feared. The end's coming, Shadow Man. An ancient prophecy tells of the return of a great evil to Deadside. A terrible force gathering dark souls to its darker
nope,
heart and using their power to cross over into this
favorite.
World and bring about.
Again, I'm not going to ask if that's
I must
real
stop
life
this evil from bringing about the end of all things.
Only you can do it, Shadow Man. You are the walker between
God.
The worlds.
Yeah.
I can't go Deadside, and Jaunty's next to useless in both worlds. You are the only one
you guys
who
always
can
give
do
me
anything
shit that
about
I'm not
this.
Eating healthy.
As it ever was.
But you ain't never confronted anything like this evil. It's so pure, not even the ancient protectors
no,
of the dark souls
to.
Could destroy it. They could only banish it from Deadside. They knew it'd come back one day.
Oh boy.
Hence the prophecy telling of its return. The power
Man.
Of the ancients is
yeah,
all but gone
is
now.
Great.
And the dark souls that evil desires lie unprotected.
40, huh?
What you gotta do, Shadow Man, is to go Deadside and recover the dark souls. Take
I
them
really
into your
like
own
how
protection
the Shadow Man game
before
like,
evil gathers
you
them
to already
its
know who Shadow Man is and what his deal
okay,
is.
Okay, so let me get this straight.
Yeah.
If I don't recover these dark souls,
wait,
then
dark
the world's going to end.
Man.
Am I right?
You got it.
There's dark souls
Shit.
In Shadow Man.
Look, I gotta go.
The original dark
I've got
souls.
A lot to do. Take Deacon's file and meet me at dawn at the church on the hill. I've kept your stuff safe
oh,
for
there's
you.
There's that lady.
I hate this shit. Just a pawn in Nettie's master plan.
Walk over here.
She moves me in mysterious ways. And brother, sometimes she really does move me. Can't do nothing about it since, nice
they
as
really
you please, she knitted
yeah.
my ribs into the mask of shadows. I got nothing left anyways.
They've heard
my fault
that there's
Luke's dead,
a
and mom and pop too. I deserve everything
Jamaica
I get. Every
well, no,
bad thing that
like
comes
real
my way.
Accents, but they think
can't
it's
live,
real Jamaican,
can't
and
die.
They do it badly.
Deadside's the perfect hood for me. A nowhere place. The asshole of the universe.
Every off-brand comic book character you have never heard of is either Batman or Wolverine. Or they're
yeah.
Cable, but more.
So is Spawn a, well, no, we haven't. We have heard of Spawn, never mind.
Damn.
Cable, but what
so
if the
I
guns were...
I you about the Sonic the
more.
Hedgehog comic books.
The Sonic the Hedgehog comic books aren't real.
No.
So Archie Comics made a series of Sonic comic
yeah,
books.
Yeah, and they're not real.
And as I've talked about, they go places.
Yeah.
I love going places.
Army the Bee gets brain damage and forgets about the fact that he abandoned his kingdom before it was genocided by Dr. Robotnik.
You've talked about this.
Yeah. Listen, you could say literally anything versus... about the Ken Penders run of Sonic comics, and I'd go, yeah, sure, of course. Literally anything.
So now that there's a blockbuster,
there's the Mega Man.
Go ahead.
There's a Sonic versus Mega Man crossover series in there, and Mega Man kills Sonic and then gains speed, Speed Force.
Good. That's the way things should go.
I mean, there are more better Mega Man games than there are Sonic, good Sonic games.
But there are so many Mega Man games. That's not saying much.
I do not have a double jump.
Yeah,
I'm just man right now. I'm not even Shadow Man. Sure,
but even though there might be that many Mega Man games, most of those Mega Man games, the proportion, even when you do it like proportionally, per capita, there are more good Mega Man games per capita than there are good Sonic games per capita.
How many Mega Man games are truly wretched?
Yeah. Very few.
And it's like X7, right?
It feels like there's a different standard applied with like Mega Man and Sonic because of their genres. Like, most Mega Man games hate you actively.
That's just because they're NES games. I know, and also, I don't know, you seem to think every game hates you. Also, yeah, Mighty No. 9 is the worst Mega Man game.
Okay, well, yes, of course. Every game does hate me. They're all out to get me. I'm not paranoid, you're paranoid.
What?
What?
Did I forget to... Oh, god damn it! I have to do this all over again. Shit!
Maybe the real bad series was every single time ZP plays an adventure game. Made it.
It's almost as if adventure games are a bad genre.
Nettie?
Hey there, Mike.
Fuck.
Glad you could make it.
How could I refuse your offer? How could I ever refuse you, Agneta?
You can't. I'm simply irresistible. I hope you read the file I gave you, and read it real well. Between the lines, you'll find the signs.
But I did go in that direction.
You got my stuff?
Come on in, honey.
This is going
to
be the part
you know,
where
on the way over here, I got to thinking about these
skin.
Dark souls. If they're so damn dangerous, why didn't the ancients
cheating
just destroy them?
In the game.
Because that's impossible.
Not cheating if it's in the
game.
Their
power
no
is their immortality. If evil ever manages to implant these immortal souls into its monstrous slaves, can you imagine the carnage an immortal, unbeatable army would bring to the Earth? That's apocalypse, Shadowman. That's the end.
Okay. So I really gotta get to the Dark Souls before the bad guy. I understand that. But where do I find him?
In Govi. Each Govi has been sealed by the most powerful voodoo. Not even the greatest Vokor or Mambo can open them to release the Dark Soul within.
So the Visa thing is just the sponsor. We don't have to call them by the sponsor.
Or something even more powerful.
But RB
Racing is very
dumb.
Release the Dark Soul. And take it into
yourself.
But it's
not Arby's.
But be warned.
No, it's not Arby's, sadly.
It should
an
be.
Ancient evil,
it's like right bumper
power racing. That should not be
listen,
abused.
If Arby's
okay.
Would like to sponsor me.
Let's just get this thing over with. You got my stuff?
Right here.
Arby's isn't even that good.
Yeah, but I'd take a sponsorship from them.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, the heartbeat.
Jesus, Luke. He's alive. Alive and in pain. I gotta help him.
Yeah, he's so dead, Mike. You know that.
I know, but I saw...
It's understandable that you still have strong feelings for your brother.
So
that's why the bear works for you, connecting you to
like
Deadside. Use it now, Mike.
Nowhere.
Go Deadside
like,
and find
no,
Jinty.
Like,
he's waiting for
thing.
You at the Meadow Gates. He's got something to show you.
Okay.
And
sucks.
Mike?
Yeah?
That
if
sucks.
You need me,
that's a bullshit
I'll be here.
Thing.
Now, go see Jinty and get them Dark Souls.
Get them Dark Souls.
So is Shadow Man dubious?
Ah!
Certainly looks like it.
It's a N64 PSX.
I am the Lord of Deadside.
Yeah. Like, what do you
Shadowborn
want?
At the confluence of worlds to walk between.
I want something as
life side as is
I
without
want.
The meaning that my partly living possesses here in Deadside, where the darkness is manifest.
I did, but no one ever wants to go to the Clonk Tower.
As a god, I step forth upon the writhing, separating surface of the Deadside
serpent. And then, if we're one step away from the Clonk Tower, that means
what dreams there are in the unctuous coilings of the snake's mortal shuffling.
I mean, there are like two or three sequels to
hand,
that game.
The arcing
so
death
that
blow
play.
At the
yeah.
end of
to
all
get, like, the
things.
Full,
the
universe.
Horror. The
yeah.
horror.
Braden, there's a universe.
I what a... embrace it.
No comment?
The Clonk Tower.
What?
Clonk Tower.
Clonk Tower.
Clonk Tower. Clock Tower.
Yeah. You know how many Clock Tower games there are?
There's a lot.
Several.
And most of them are good.
In quotations. Please clarify that you mean in quotations.
I mean, I try to put the emphasis on the syllable too.
I
you know,
yeah,
that's
listen.
Good.
Stop with the dilly dallying, Michael.
Hello there, Michael. How's that treating you?
Now Jody, I need to use
kindly
the
refer
wrench
to me as Shadow Man. Michael Lawa has no place here in Deadside. Yeah.
Whatever, Mick. It's good to see you again. Seems like simply ages since I last set
there
the eyes
a
on you.
Comically talking
about a
the feeling is mutual.
Snake
I suppose you've been away dallying with the
Irish
old battle axe, giving her one with some of that righteous voodoo so
hey,
she can stay forever young.
Something like that.
She's been filling your head with her fated pillow talk again, I bet. Doomsday in an army, Gideon till you're drunk with that
Shadow of Man.
She didn't happen to mention a certain prophetic dream she's been having.
Did she now? Well, for once I think the Owl Witch might be right. See that bloody big black tower yonder?
How could I miss it?
Well, old Bruegel, the medieval painter blokey, was just telling me the other day that he thought it looked remarkably like a picture he once did.
Is that Peter Bruegel?
No, Seamus, his distant Irish cousin. Anyways, he was quite shocked, so he was, at that terrible mess that bloody did. Appearing out of nowhere and tearing its way through the place like there's no tomorrow. Which, given what Nettie's saying, might not be too far from the truth.
Any idea what's going on in there?
Nope, and I shan't be knocking on the front door to find out, neither. All I'd say is, if there's something wicked heading this way, it'll be coming from in there.
Nettie mentioned the Dark Souls. Can you tell me any more about them?
No.
I'm afraid I'll have to reply in the negative again, Michael. Suffice it to say, Nettie's told me that they're bloody powerful, well-nigh indestructible, and shouldn't fall into the wrong hands.
Any idea where they might be?
There's
a Dark Soul travel guide now. I suppose you could try all of the ancient sacred places down
fine.
Amongst the wailers and shiverers.
The implications
the
just hope that none of them souls have ended up in that filthy big black tower.
From what Nettie was saying, some of them already
like
have, which is all the more reason for me to be pushing on.
Open
the gates, Johnny.
Places to go, people to see, eh, Michael?
Just open the gates, Johnny.
Did I ever tell you about the time me and Attila the Hun were playing skittles with the guillotine heads of the French aristocracy?
Johnny.
All right, keep your bloody hair on. Which, looking at your shining bonds, may prove to be rather difficult. Open sesame!
I know, everything you hear about, like...
And if you'd be wanting to pop by and chat a while, I'll still be here.
He's a very nice man.
Oh, speaking of Labyrinth, I'm pretty sure that the original Clock Tower,
Great.
They just
huh?
drew...
Great. Yeah.
What's her name?
They just traced Jennifer Connelly, yeah.
They just traced Jennifer Connelly for the character sprite. Which, A+. Fantastic misuse of someone's.
Yeah, I am so grateful that I have used.
All right, so this is my shadow.
It's an Indiana Jones reference. Haha, cool. Get it? And then Indiana, fake Indiana Jones, fell into
this
the lava.
Is the
Guess
dead
what?
Side.
Sierra did
the
a joke about
the nothing beyond the bone-backed
no
gates. Here, Luke, my dear lost
they were
brother,
rivals.
Wanders
Apparently,
alone
like, they
amidst the aimless ranks of those who cannot die. He
well,
still,
surprise,
with
surprise.
The ache for death,
hey,
I too may discover within my
creativity.
Blighted heart.
Unlike what
here,
everybody else in this room thinks.
Darkness at the heart of all things.
I mean, I'm not the one who's wandering
real.
Through a
What we see
Welcome to the maze of death.
As a dead man's gaze, as cold as the light from a dying star.
Pretty on par because we have a.
He's going there, and then he'll. He's going there, and then he'll be there.
Okay. God, if you do not pick fast animation for this, you are. I pray for
you. Shadow Man is definitely a game where you go there and then be there, is what I'm saying. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you ever played a video game that came out between the years, let's say, 1996 and 2001?
No.
Shadow Man has.
What the hell? Okay.
Shadow Man looks like half a step removed from like an early Xbox game. But I guess it's because it's remastered.
That, this is the Nigeria Master. The N64 version did not look this good.
Becoming small man far away. This is a funny joke. Al Lowe's a genius.
I think it's the rock textures that are making me think of like bad early Xbox games.
You're a bad Xbox. I think it's texture.
Yeah.
I am. Thank you.
I'll talk to that.
How do you feel being a bad Xbox texture, Mr. Unreal?
I feel about 480p about it.
Not even. You're probably 16 by 9.
Aren't they supposed to be 16 by 9? But don't. Does mean 4
damn.
By
9. Damn!
Wouldn't like that.
Damn!
So you mean 320 by 240?
Yes, exactly. Someone actually, the one person here knows what they're talking about.
Okay. I'm gonna touch the pole.
Oh, what? God damn
Please
it.
Please do not touch your pole
it's
on
one
screen.
Of these pole, it's one of these puzzles, huh? Damn it. So, it's my favorite puzzle. It's the puzzle where we need to figure out the pattern for getting rid of all these things, make them all disappear, crisscross applesauce.
So, if I remember correctly, this is an Acclaim joint.
Yeah!
Because I believe Shadow Man is from the same licensing deal that brought us Turok.
Of course. Wait, so this is what, Dark Horse Comics or something?
It's not Dark Horse, it's,
Got it. I just died.
It's not 2000 AD.
Aha! The joke here is that the person teasing me is got an Arnold Schwarzenegger accent. Cool.
Because this isn't terrible enough to be 2000 AD.
No.
That man was my governor during much of my childhood.
I mean, you know, people...
I am the Lord of Deadside.
People, you know... The Darkness comics are apparently quite bad.
Looks I can like imagine. What other trashy comic book labels were there? The 90s.
Oh, God.
Oh,
look at this dope art.
Fuck this. This is one of the worst. Oh, this.
Okay. Yep.
You got tarot cards.
Oh, God. Look at this map.
Hold on. I'm a few seconds behind. Oh no, that map. Oh no. Oh no.
This is bad. Want a hint
That's
so you don't hit yourself later?
Map.
There are
a few other maps as dubious as that.
I realize that this puzzle is you have to jump on all the stones.
Valiant Comics?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that checks out.
Let's talk about independent comics. Okay. So,
let's talk about what's it called? Gold Digger.
I've gone deeper into Deadside and discovered a place that only Shadow Men may enter.
It was
but
bought
I'll be
by
damned if I can find a Dark Soul. Huh.
You will be damned if you don't get yourself together, Shadow Man. The prophecy is taking effect. You found a path of
armor
shadow
aids.
Built
so this
by your predecessor, Maxim
like
Saint
getting
James.
This square part is
Search
easy.
The path for the so gold. And when you find
up,
one, use
east.
Your shadow powers to open it. Now get to it.
North, west, west, down, 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 down. They have to be in the lava. It has to be, yeah, it has to be every stone. Got it. This.
Ooh, there's a Shadow Man sequel for the PS2.
There sure That's is. Great. They made
I bet
two
it's
of
great.
These suckers.
Well,
if it isn't the old friend, Mike, have you found nothing yet?
I've discovered a place that only Shadow Men can enter, but I have yet to collect a Dark Soul.
I seem to recall one of your predecessors, Maxim St. James, fun. A Shadow Man of some repute,
oh,
I might add, explaining
video,
to me that he'd had some time on his
yes.
hands one aeon. And I'd set about building a safe
yes,
route through Deadside. Parts of Shadow
this
was what
I'm
called.
Playing right now. Is
that is the place I've discovered. Dark it is, and rank with the stench of defilement.
That sounds like St. James. Of course, it's anyone's guess where the path paths lead to now after that filthy black tower tore the place up.
I must return to the paths of Shadow and continue my search for Govi.
And when you find one, use
That's
your shadow powers. Shoot it with your bloody gun
okay,
if you have to. That'd be the way to get
friends.
The dark soul out of it.
For once, I believe I'm going to take your advice.
Good luck with
you. Always rely on me.
I think I got it.
Always is too long a time to rely on anyone, especially a skull-headed snake.
Oh, and Mikey.
I'm a genius.
Yes.
I hope you can remember your
I'm the greatest puzzleman.
So what's your favorite independent comic book?
Anything by Dark Horse. Also, the Dark Horse Star Wars comics. Shut up. I know I can hear you judging me. I can
Does
hear
Dark
you judging
Horse
me.
Count as an independent label.
When
or is
they
it
were
just
independent.
The label?
Image like, Comics counts, right?
Oh yeah, Image, yeah. Yeah, well Image was bought though, wasn't it?
Yeah, they were.
Yeah.
I think that's it. Yeah.
Yeah, there aren't many left these days.
I mean, like, let's be honest, like, the webcomics, for all of their not great consequences for the major labels, they did kind of pioneer just self-publisher
they
stuff on a website.
Yeah,
yeah, they democratized
like,
comics.
Like the Mega Tokyo. Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean,
webcomics.
So, I not to, like, make this bit a big thing, but, like, I talked to someone who was in the webcomic thing, but basically what happens is if you get enough traffic on your website, publisher will usually approach you saying, can we do a limited run physical printing of your stuff? And basically 70% of those deals are complete busts, but 30% carries everything. And then sometimes, you know, you get to put it on your store.
You know, I respect the people still making webcomics, except for the Penny Arcade guys.
Hey.
You even respect Control-Alt-Delete?
Yeah.
Wow.
Because at this point, that man,
he made a joke?
He's just,
Wait,
he
fuck?
Is, he is a joke.
Hey.
That's what I have to say about that.
I mean, I feel like. Can I rotate them? No.
I mean,
oh, no.
I'm personally not going to make the jokes that I want to make. So, you know, they should thank me for my restraint.
This should be useful.
I got a Dark Soul!
The power of the
Which
Dark
one?
Souls.
One, two, or three?
I embrace
the first
it.
One. Now I could do a charge shot, I guess? Or maybe I could always do a charge... Yeah, now I could do a charge shot.
That's it, isn't it? Oh, does it have to do every crystal? Damn it, damn it, damn it.
And
I didn't realize it had to be every crystal.
Actually, so it's actually the legend of the crystals, like plural.
Great.
Still looking for that, like... Burns. I gotta be honest, Brayden. I'm still looking for that rush of, like, the early hand-animated adventure game where we're playing, like, Pink Panther games.
Those See, games that's your problem. Man. You're not playing the Pink Panther games.
Those games were something, man.
I mean, they can't all be, like, deranged.
Yeah, also, those Pink Panther games were made by,
Isn't that it?
That is literally the two games Unsalvaged that studio souls made.
That drift beyond the narrow gates for an eternity
oh,
awaiting.
Oh, does it actually have to this be the infinite pattern? Limbo, oh, I see.
This wasteland.
Damn it.
This untamed, unnatural...
I mean, God, these monologues.
...land with my endless darkness.
Could you
what
be any more 90s comic?
What ineffable secrets are whispered within the paths of shadow?
No.
What red-eyed realities rising bleak above the blasted
skyline? I mean, you could be more 90s comic if you were
Deadwing.
Cable.
Duppy,
oh, I, the laser has to be
mother,
down.
What about Steel?
This voodoo lord outlasts them all.
What are your thoughts on Steel?
With Shaquille O'Neal?
You mean all of my favorite? You mean the death of Superman? The most 90s comic
too.
Book arc, this side of the Clone Saga?
Yes. What do you think of Blade?
What do
Blade's
I think of
great.
Blade?
Blade's great.
I got nothing against Blade.
Blade's amazing. Like, that first movie?
He's one of the best characters in Midnight Suns.
He's also one of the best pre-Marvel Renaissance Marvel movie franchises. Before Tobey Maguire, at least. I mean, I do like the first two Tobey Maguire Spider-Man.
Well, yeah, of course.
That second movie is great. Like, genuinely
it's
good.
Yeah, because Alfred Molina is great.
Man, and they brought him back.
They brought him back, but at least that wasn't that bad when they brought him back.
No, that was a return that made sense.
Like, also, I think
Corny 88, I decided that... So, Corny 88, I decided to make an executive decision. I ain't... doing this on the default speed. I sped up his walking animation. I cannot do this anymore. I just can't.
Wow.
I cannot.
Wow, coward shit. Does Shadow Man have a breath meter? Or
no,
is it just vibes?
I'm...
Hey, Brayden, how's
the
animation, facial animations in your game compared to my game?
Better.
Because
there are none.
There are some.
Shadow Man doesn't have facial animation, which makes it better.
Facial animation, man. I don't know. This seems fine.
Yeah,
this is maybe
fine
not
for
the Night Diver Master I would point to as a something to be excited about.
I mean, this is no medieval.
Oh, God. Look at this thing.
No.
Look
I believe
at
the medieval
him.
One was done by Sony.
Look.
Oh, okay.
Fork. Look at the Snuffleupagus.
Jeez.
Look at this Snuffleupagus. Are you watching?
Yeah, I see it. I see it. And no, I'm not going to clip it out.
Aww.
M's already mad at us.
Why is M mad at you?
Because I figured out that I could add emojis.
Oh, shit, he's dead.
So I'm trying not to abuse that power.
Dr. Boogle! Touch me there, Dr. Boogle.
Show me on the doll where Boogle touched you.
All over the face.
Like, I think the
Boogle's
soundtrack to this
mouth
game
to mouth.
Is, like,
Google.
Cool. I think...
Of the Legacy of Kain games, is Shadow Man better than?
Better than One Omen 2, at least, thus far.
Okay.
But the thing about the Legacy of Kain games is that you just can't compare to homoerotic vampire soliloquy.
And also John Jay.
And Tony Jay.
Tony Jay.
John
Jay,
one of the
father.
Writers of the Federalist
also
Papers,
founding,
I understand.
Yeah, a founding father and a starting member of the Supreme Court, if I recall correctly.
The first Chief Justice, I believe.
So I like the hand painted backgrounds. These 3D backgrounds, I hate them. I hate Sierra's 3D backgrounds. They're 2D backgrounds. They're hand painterly stuff. It's the same problem I have with the third Legend of Carandia game. Looks bad, man. Makes me feel bad.
Well, 3D's the future, old man.
All right, and also you called me a coward, so I guess I'll lower the walking speed to normal.
There you go. See, you see, kids, bullying works. Wait, so Shadow Man is like the Shadow Man of Death or whatever, but he can still burn up in lava?
Yeah, I'm the Shadow Man.
There's only weakness, lava.
So I gave you a hard time, Brayden.
Irish snake.
About playing Shadow Mordor.
Yeah.
Shadow Mandor.
What are the mainstream games that you will not play?
On stream?
Yeah.
God damn it.
Because you said you would never play God of War.
I would never play the new God of War.
Hmm.
I believe there is, in fact, video evidence of me playing
you
the
did
PSP
a, If you
God
did
of
your wheel of dubious character action games and picked, like, one of the PSP God of War games, I'm gonna pray for you.
Those are dubious,
motherfucker,
though.
I played Chains of Olympus on stream at one point.
I know. I'm gonna pray
those
for you because
dubious.
I agree those are dubious.
Those games are not bad enough.
They're not bad. Those aren't bad games. Those are, like, some of the better PSP games. I mean, that's not saying much.
That's a good gag.
Anyway,
get that gag?
The Wheel of Dubious character action games, that'll happen at some point. Nope. Okay, they really don't want me to
That was
that
a pretty
joke.
Good gag. I like that joke. I forgot that joke is in the game. So he is crawling around on the screen and he bumps into the menu and he asks you to get rid of the menu.
Wow, that's some next level humor.
I mean, let's not forget about the Space Quest game.
Yeah, like Ascension is the one I would play for
Sierra. No. Ascension is dubious.
Because Ascension is the
dubious God of War.
Oh god, this console generation has gone on for too long game.
It's like Gears of War Judgment, but worse.
Yeah, because Gears of War Judgment's good.
Yes.
And by good, I mean entirely
in the
context
of... Is this the part
of...
where Brayden's gonna piss me off and he's gonna put DMC?
No. Once again, that game is not dubious.
No,
thank
that game
you.
Isn't dubious.
I would put Heavenly Sword on there.
Yeah,
good. What's rocking?
Oh, God, Harley, you're loud.
Devil May Cry 2 is dubious.
Yeah.
Yeah, Devil May Cry 2 I played through for charity.
Oh, I'm sorry.
There,
oh, I know.
All of it. Okay. I played through all of
all
Devil
of
May Cry 2 for charity.
All of it. Would Bullet Witch count
police
as a character
state.
Action game?
God damn it, I got arrested by the Popo, the Fuzz,
I
Police
don't,
State.
I own it. Bullet Witch. Would it surprise
the
you if someone
state.
Gifted me
Police
Bullet Witch?
Police State.
Wait, sorry, I can't hear you. Does that count as character action?
I don't know if it does.
Does what count as character action?
Snuffleupagus. Evil Snuffleupagus. I'm in jail because of the plant police state.
And Shadow of the Damned is a shooter, right?
Yeah.
What about Never Dead?
Do you want me to... No, that's a shooter, too. If you want, I can pull up my list that I have.
Ooh, and... yeah, stream your list.
I made this list a while
tier list.
Ago.
We can make your tier list of dubious character action games.
I can share you.
Oh god,
right now.
That really is an idea for Brayden if he ever wants to like half-ass it. Is like, why don't you do a tier list of your previous seasons?
Oh, there are 666 hearts.
No.
Yeah.
Evil
yeah.
Snuffleupagus took Boogle. Whatever.
And there
shall
are 120 Dark Souls.
Oh, that's too many Dark Souls.
Anyway, no, let me just... This is what the list is so far. Yaiba, Ninja Gaiden Z, Ninja Blade,
yeah.
Garshasp, Conan, the
Which
the,
one?
The Xbox 360 Conan the Barbarian game.
Ooh, okay.
X-Blades and its sequel, Blades of Time, Venetica,
oh, yeah.
question mark.
Oh, okay.
Killer is Dead. Wanted Dead,
yeah.
Lollipop Chainsaw, Heavenly
yeah.
Sword, Devil's Third, the Sega 360 era games based on Captain America and Thor.
Oh no.
Viking Battle for Asgard, Spartan Total Warrior,
yeah.
That Legend of Korra yeah. game,
yep.
Marlo Briggs,
huh?
Castlevania Curse of Darkness, and Layman of Innocence, and Lords of
Is
Shadow 2.
Is Layman of Innocence not bad?
Eh.
Oh, okay.
People, you gotta mix it up.
Okay.
El Shaddai, Rise of the Metatron, Rise Son of Rome. I guess
yeah.
technically I've been playing Evil West with Joku, so that probably wouldn't be on there. Also, Evil
El
West
Shaddai's weird.
Evil West is very stupid.
Yeah.
The Splatterhouse reboot for 360.
Oh god.
Star
oh,
Wars
god.
The Force Unleashed 2.
Yeah.
The PS2 Altered Beast game that didn't come out over here.
Oh. Oh no.
Something called some Seven Samurai 20XX.
Yeah, I told you
oh.
about that game.
Yeah,
there's
you
a
did,
rap
and
scene.
That's why I put it on the list. Onaichambara
Origins. There's a rap
Origins,
scene in that game.
Final Fight Streetwise
yeah,
and
exactly.
Darksiders 3? Question mark.
Ooh, that's a spicy take.
I don't know. I mean, it sounds like that game also might just be more Dark Souls than character action.
Huh.
And
so
also,
that's what the
puzzle is. I don't know. It seems like that game might just be. Compromised by a
what's the
Eurojack budget?
I gotta talk to the flower for like 6 or 7.
Needs
times.
Other M.
Cool.
You're right.
Oh, other M. Yeah.
But that would shut off my previous plan for content, which was Metroid Other M, where I play Metroid Other M with my friend M Paladino.
I guarantee.
Oh yeah, the other
M will M will.
Uh-huh. And will.
I bet I could persuade Em to pick it for the podcast.
She
picked Shadow the Hedgehog.
Yeah, she's not innocent.
Okay.
The Dark Souls are mine.
Here are some other dubious character action games. You had a lot on there. That was
yeah.
That was a good list.
Yeah, God of War Ascension, I...
Yeah, that one should be on there.
That's the one that should be on there, because here's the thing about Chains of Olympus and Ghost of Sparta. Both
fine.
Of those games are actually pretty good.
Yeah, they're fine.
Like, they're PSP games, so they're,
I
like,
don't like how this flower looks.
I always thought it was really strange that those games never got, like, a port over the PlayStation 3 or the PS2.
They did.
Did they?
They did.
Yeah.
Yeah. They're HD remasters.
I have the HD ports on PS3.
Yeah.
Okay. I didn't see them, because, like, those were actually kind of critical story, like, bits of story
uh-huh.
for
Well,
yeah.
Ghost of Sparta, I know, tries to kind of redeem Kratos after God of War 3.
Yeah.
Kratos did not need redemption after God of War 3. He was justified in everything he did. I say that having recently played through the game again.
Athena, I am angry!
Kratos,
you must not
do
things.
Dante's Inferno.
I am angry!
Dante's Inferno, right?
Already played through Dante's Inferno.
Dongus.
Okay.
There is a clip of ZP and I talking about games that we will play for Off the Deep End. And then Satan's dick shows up.
As you do.
Also, it turns out the Ryan's Inferno dungeon is actually genuinely shitty. I thought maybe Ryan was just having a reviewer's moment.
The end of that game was just combat
moment.
Challenge rooms. It's real bad.
Those challenge rooms actually bad.
Here's the thing I'll say about Shadow Man. I'm not having a bad time.
Yeah, it looks playable.
I think this game, especially for something from, you know, the 90s or
1999.
Okay.
Year of
like,
our Lord,
it's got cool vibes.
It does?
It's got cool art style?
Relatively, I guess.
Oh, those are the silkworms?
Like, compare this to what was coming out on the N64.
I mean, is this better than Buck Bumble?
Biggity Buck Bumble.
Biggity Buck Bumble.
You can't buck to the bump to the bump to the bass. Buck to the bump to the bumble.
Bump, buck to the buck, but biggity buck bumble.
I like the remixes of Buck Bumble's theme. Like, people who have remixed Buck Bumble theme to, like, Undertale theme, Megalovania. Yeah.
Sure.
People who have taken, like, the Super Mario Bros. Re-theme and put it to Buck Bumble.
Yeah.
Like, degenerate stuff.
The power of the Dark Souls, I embrace it.
But, yeah, I'm gonna be honest here. I'm having an alright time with this.
Dauber plant.
Like, I think it controls just fine.
Yeah, okay. The WWK. Well, see, here's the thing. There kind of were very few N64 games until, like, mid-1998.
I like how the plant is red in the environment, and then when I picked it, it's green.
Like, go look up the 1997 releases for the N64.
Shadow,
it's
hey,
like,
Shadows of the
it's
Empire.
Like,
oh no, this tree has a face.
Like, it's kind of dire. So yeah, it wasn't until like 99, 2000, 2001 that you actually had decent games.
Ooh, this tree's covered in some very sticky stuff.
That weren't like Mario or Zelda on the N64.
Oh no, this animation.
Like, it was an extremely slow build-up for that console. Like, they should have gotten
away with it. Because they were too busy alienating all of their Japanese developers.
Like, I cannot think of another console that had much of a slow rollout that didn't fail miserably.
Who? What? I'm sorry, I was busy.
The Nintendo 64, have you heard of it?
Okay, yeah, sorry. I thought we were talking about the original Xbox.
No, there's an Xbox like came out like tried to come out swinging.
Splinter Cell came out in 2002.
It just whiffed, you know, a lot of the time.
It Halo, did well. It Halo. Did well enough in the North America audience, and it did well enough in Europe. And hey, they basically bought all of those Sega Dreamcast people to just join.
Like,
and some
the
weird stuff came out.
The issue with the PS4 Xbox One generation is like
PS2 1.
Okay, yes. For the PS4, like that cross gen era was extended, is the issue there. So it's hard to really judge it at this point because it didn't become its own thing until like 2016, which is absurd.
I'm gonna get that sap to you. Aha! The sappy tree is a sentimental sap. It's a pun.
I don't get it. But yeah, the 360 got the jump in just the right way. They made it work when Sega couldn't. They're helped by Ken Kutaragi losing his damn mind. That first year of 360 games is really something. Yeah. Like if I weren't doing blogs on like the 90s games, I'd be doing a blog on that first year of 360 games because it's, yeah.
Dude,
it's a spread.
I know I sound weird, but that 360 launch has a diversity to it.
Yeah,
in hindsight.
Yeah.
Like, it's got Condemned. It's got a bad.
It's got Condemned
Twisted
and
Metal
Cameo.
Clone. It's got all those weird XBLA games where Geometry Wars was like the weird killer app. Yeah,
when Xbox Live Arcade had
games?
A hard limit of 50 megabytes.
Remember when that didn't matter?
Yeah.
Those mini games were like you didn't need that much.
And then they did.
And then, yeah, Geometry Wars. Like, maybe one of the most important games to come out for the 360. Like, not the most important game. It's clearly Call of Duty 4.
Call of Duty 4 was multi-platform.
I don't know. Like, that game did so well on Xbox that it is kind of synonymous with the Xbox 360. But, I mean, at launch, the 360 also had Call of Duty 2.
Yeah, they did. And in full HD. It was mind-blowing. 720p was mind-blowing. All right, like, yeah, like, for all the kids out there watching the Shadow Man stream,
yes.
Like, let me tell you what, the 720p transition was mind-blowing.
Hello, fellow youths, let me tell you about 720p's. Let me tell you about, okay, so Christmas 2005.
Uh-huh.
We are doing Christmas with, one of my dad's partners. And he's into games, and he got an Xbox 360, and I just played the opening levels of Call of Duty 2.
Whoops.
Okay, that I clearly get to have to drain that lava somehow.
I remember really liking Stalingrad level in Call of Duty 2.
Yeah. Wait, was PGR3 a launch game, or is that like in the months afterwards? PGR3 was launch, right?
I will say launch window.
Yeah,
because Dead or Alive 4 was technically not launched.
I know that 4 was like January, February. Yeah.
I know that the Xbox is synonymous with like a bunch of racing games. I miss PGR.
PGR
I miss
so
the Kudos
good.
System. I realize that basically Forza Horizon is
Forza Horizon
PGR,
does that.
RIP.
Yes.
Well,
but I like having non-open world street racing.
I'm the Lord. I mean, there is still the need for speed. That's unbound these days.
I would also say that the 360's Ridge Racer game, I always preferred over the PS3's Ridge Racer game.
I can see that. Oh, how can we possibly forget? Most Wanted was a launch game, right?
Oh, yeah.
Ridge Callahan.
FMV cutscenes still are great. The fact that the remake got rid of them is a crime against humanity. Although they probably couldn't, they didn't pay the actors.
Yeah, Ridge Callahan was for the 360 launch, and so was Dead
and
Rising.
I will say that
hell
final race against Ridge Callahan is fucked.
I think Dead Rising was,
Wait, was that 06?
That was 06.
Ah, damn. But that was still first year of the 360. Like that bizarre window between like the launch of the 360 and the launch of the PS3 was a wild time.
The game for me, this is gonna sound weird, like the game for me that actually made me convinced that this is a next generation game, was Ghost Recon Advanced Warfighter, because that genuinely felt like a game.
Yeah.
That I could not play on an Xbox, and when I did see what it looked like on Xbox, it did not look as good.
Yep.
And it did not have the same, like, mid-step between, like, the hardcore team tactical
into asylum
Ghost Recon stuff with, like, more arcade shooting. Like, that game's great. I love that
ravaging the already benighted landscape with
its malevolent
presence. Oh, yeah, those two. Like that era of Clancy games was good.
Insanity,
that was a good era of Clancy
sheer
games.
And stark. And once in
they were
human
still making
form,
good Splinter
now gutted and torn by eons
yeah,
of glutted
indulgence.
That was
indulgence. Double Agent, was that time.
Their bloodlust
like
flecking the oily walls,
people
living in
the
shrieks
Xbox
of victims ensnared,
Agent.
Hanged, drawn, and quartered by the serpent's squalid
writhings.
This
level
is the place I have not wanted to dream of. And the dream is now the place I partly live through.
Special Conviction was like 2010, right?
Yeah. Because Conviction was originally going to be like Assassin's Creed, and then they hard rebooted it.
Yeah.
And you know,
then the multiplayer mode for that was like it was in Unreal Engine 2 for some reason.
Oh shit!
The PS3. Well, the PS3 got going in 2007 with Uncharted. Like they did have the Uncharted game. So they had something going on there?
I said this yesterday, but I think that the first Uncharted game's bad.
Yeah, it's not good, but it was a big deal. Like, the Demon's Souls was 2008. So, the PS3 got going in 08. And I can't believe you're discounting the PS3 launch games like Genji, Day of the Blade.
I thought about putting that on the list.
Why didn't you?
Because I feel like that's a little too close to a Musou.
Okay. Oh, so why wouldn't Onimusha be a dubious character action game?
Because those games are Resident Evil.
Oh, okay.
Those games are the awkward half step.
But the
first DMC is a character action game.
Yeah, it is. And okay. Onimusha is the awkward middle child between DMC and Resident Evil. At least the first Onimusha.
Okay.
That's the only one I've played.
Then you should stream Onimusha 3 with Jean Reno.
Yeah, with Jean Reno.
I miss Jean Reno.
Is he still alive?
Yes, he's still alive. He's not in movies anymore.
Good.
I think he retired.
Good for him.
Yeah, good for him.
Oh, I see. This is Ganon's tower.
You're fighting the pig man.
From watching speedruns, I know that bunny hopping is actually the fastest way to move.
And Shadow Man?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, this was that era.
I ought to go visit Nettie.
Alright. God damn. Just look at this.
Hi there.
This 3D-ery.
3D-ery.
3D was hard.
I mean, you tried doing 3D modeling on a Windows 3.1 machine.
I followed the Dark Souls trail into the asylum, but where the hell are the five?
They're in this
really,
world, Shadow Man.
Yep.
Five mortal men touched
DOS
by the power of the Dark Souls.
Okay.
Unlike you, they don't have the Mask of Shadows controlling and channeling the dark power. It twists their minds, fills their already tainted hearts with even greater perversions, and a hatred so terrible it has sent them insane.
Every single
okay,
one that's,
so
no,
they're
no,
in
no,
this
no,
world,
that
but where exactly?
That's your
that,
job,
that
Shadow
not,
Man. You gotta go back to the
fight?
Asylum and
no,
find
no.
a way
no.
through.
Really?
The same way the Dark
That's
Souls
later.
Found their way into the
That's
fire.
That's kind of crazy, actually.
Hunt the mothers down, Shadow Man, and
like,
kick their sorry
every
asses.
Retrospective I've
but
ever
remember,
listened to
they possess an
game.
Immortal power,
like,
and only by taking their souls will you truly
that it was
defeat
a launch title.
Them. Well, they're wrong.
They're wrong. Like, it's
were,
very clearly
were children?
Not.
Were they there at the time?
Like, you could even say that Amp 3 was like a launch window title, even though it wasn't a launch title.
Amp 3. I mean, that was November 2005. That was a launch title.
Oh, no. Amp 3 was the first, like, budget 360 game where it was priced at $40. Yeah, it was $39.99 at launch.
Oh, okay. I mean, Amp 3 is great.
Why aren't we talking about Gun?
Gun.
Yeah, there was also American Wasteland, the 360 port, where it was actually worst.
Yeah.
I really liked Gun, actually.
Oh, yeah. About Burnout 4, I think, was a... that was 06. So that was first year. Okay, DOA 4, Fight Night Round 3, Burnout Revenge, Full Auto. Okay, yeah. There's this game, I don't know if you've heard of this game, it's called The Elder Scrolls 4.
That
game
the most
sold crazy on 360.
Yeah, Blazing Angels, I remember that game.
Oh,
Warcry
right.
Instincts. Battlefield 2.
Oh, God. Yeah, like, all of those ports of earlier generation games where they put in, like, a little map pack or...
Oh, I forgot. Final Fantasy 11 came out on the 360.
It sure did.
The Battle for Middle-earth 2?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a good game.
I can play that right now.
People like that game. Chrome Hounds. Oh, Chrome Hounds. Yeah. Dead Rising was August 06. Oh, and of course, I forgot. I can't believe we forgot.
I need
Bomberman Act Zero. No one.
Mm-hmm.
Bomberman Act Zero.
I mean, Bomberman had been on a steep decline ever since like the Sega CD.
Konami, you could just say a video game by Konami wasn't great.
I need to find the.
Oh, Enchanted Arms was 06.
It sure was.
That game's okay, other than the horrible gay stereotype.
Yeah, other than the
character.
Part where the healer in your party is like this incredibly effete, flamboyant gay man who uses a saxophone.
Well, right,
to do
the
his
outfit
healing magic.
Was the thing that happened.
Hold on, actually, I'm gonna weigh in as the gay person in the
okay.
group.
Uh-huh.
He gets a pass because that was the first time I liked a dude.
Okay.
Fair enough.
Oh.
Fair enough.
But
all right.
Harley. He has the accent.
Pretty damn soon.
He talks about wearing makeup constantly and he's constantly hitting on straight dudes.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know at least 5 gay dudes that are exactly like that.
I know you're two right.
Of,
no, I can't.
Two of them are my uncles.
All right, fair.
Yeah, okay. All right,
I can't. I concede. Harley has won the debate.
I'm sorry. That's a stereotype for a reason. That's a real thing.
It's a little over the top, is all I would say.
No, you're right. It is a little over the top.
It's also coming from Japan, which has like preconceived notions of how gay people are like, which that depiction is very much a reflection of.
A certain time period.
All right. So the first Just Cause was 06. Oh, the Godfather game. Oh, that game was so bad.
I need the 3 of you to look in voice detection, this meme.
Yeah, but what about the Godfather 2, where the whole thing was like, you could be
I
the Don.
I played all that. Okay, yes. I acknowledge that meme. Fear was 06? Man, 06 was a weird year.
Yeah, I guess there was a 360 port of Fear.
Yeah, oh, yeah, Prey. 99 Nights!
I need air and quick.
Oh, was
Hell
that
yeah,
the first Prey
nights.
Where you played as a Native American dude?
Yeah.
Yes.
I fucking love that game.
99 Nights is a guilty pleasure.
Oh, I played so much Test Drive Unlimited.
Yeah.
I don't know why.
Well, hey, that was like my first... Oh my god, look at how this bunny rabbit animates. Anyways, Test Drive Unlimited was like.
What can I do for you,
me,
Michael?
I played that
I have entered
Burnout
the asylum,
Paradise,
a truly
so like,
terrible
oh,
place.
Open world racing game?
Far more dreadful than even the most twisted
yeah,
mind
yeah,
could have imagined.
Cool.
The only well, problem with Test Drive much. Unlimited.
Many has informed
all
me that I must find a way to reach for 5
the
from within
their faces
the asylum.
Animate when they talk.
It would seem that the serial killers
yeah.
Thomas Deacon profiled for us are
oh,
indeed
be, wait, so
preparing
the
for the crossing over of
the
Dark Soul armies.
Like
I know that you and I may pass freely between
War.
The worlds of Deadside and
yeah.
Lifeside, but
and
what if
Tony
the five?
Hawk Project 8?
How is
that's,
it that
yeah,
they
wild.
Have been able to
that's
journey
wild.
Across the veil
that
from the asylum to their Lifeside layers?
I know.
Well, there was that little
said,
incident with Tommy Lee's undead gang
stream.
Of war. Back.
Seemed
like an aberration at the time, but thinking about it, would have been a trial run. I know this may sound crazy, but I think you should be looking for a corpse.
Gets a pass
five
for all the
five corpses?
The way
I always say
it,
you trap two souls and keep them in a state of flux
right.
between the worlds.
We
one in dead side, the other in life
side.
Neither can cross sense. Over from one plane of existence to the
and
next.
When I die, I can use a spiritual
Ergo,
bow and arrow
a schism.
And shoot, like,
our bridge is formed between the worlds.
Blue
so,
and red
yes, you're looking for five ritually slaughtered corpses
back
somewhere
the
in the asylum.
Jaunty, there are a great many corpses
oh, really?
In the asylum.
What's that like?
Granted, but these will be special in some way. In a special
yeah, it does
way.
Suck.
It's
of course,
not
if
as
you
easy
do manage to find your way across
to
these psycho loonies, you better have your shadow powers at the ready. I got a feeling you're gonna need them.
The unfortunate fact is that the birds are still birds, and so they're not exactly what you would call smart.
I will say this. I think the opening of Prey is amazing, where you're in the bar and you got to beat up those shitty white guys that are hitting on your girlfriend, and like the bad radio is playing shitty music, and then the aliens come down.
It's always aliens too. Like,
it's just when you meet, it's just when you get to that part where you're using the alien guns and it's not Doom 3 anymore, and you meet the space Egyptians, where it's like, yes, okay, now I'm fucking
space Egyptians. Space Egyptians.
I will say, I think I remember Prey is the one where at the end, like near the end of the game, spoiler alert for a game that came out in 2006, your girlfriend gets like turned into a fucking,
yeah,
gets like Borged or something.
Yeah, she gets Borged. Yeah. Oh, when did Borgmaster, when did Quake 3 or Quake 4 come out?
Oh,
Quake
that
4
was
launch window.
Yeah.
Is that launch window? Hold on, let me check here.
That's the one where you get fucking turned into a cyborg soldier.
Yeah, you get turned into a
from a first person, in a first person point of view, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was crazy.
Not a great Quake game, but it's another guilty pleasure. Oh, look at these people. Oh boy.
Quake 4. What? Oh yeah, that was a launch game. 05. Yeah, so like fall of 05 to like summer of 07 was just a wild time. At least that's how I remember it.
Have y'all seen the fucking promotional Doom 2 popcorn bucket?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
I haven't seen it.
I have.
Look in voice attacks, Borgmaster.
Kinky. That's all I'm going to say.
Yeah, no, someone's going to do something unmentionable to that cup.
Oh, why? Why did you have to put this thought into my head? Why is this thought now in my head? Why is this thought in my head? Harley, why is this thought now in my head?
Why
was
this
thought immediately in your head? Like, that should be the first thing that comes to mind.
I wish it was dead.
I do wish it was dead, Brayden. Thank you for taking the words out of my mouth.
Oh, Harley, how do you feel about Buck to the Bump to the Bump to the Base, Buck to the Bump to the Bumble?
I don't know what the fuck you just said. Did you just have a stroke?
check voice and text above your first meme.
Biggity Buck Bumble.
This kind of sucks.
Yeah.
Yeah, it does.
It's the best thing about that game.
And the problem is that song doesn't loop. It stops.
Well, that's what YouTube is
for.
Well,
I mean, it fades in
and out. Oh, is that why you made, like, a list where it's just it constantly?
I mean, that's someone else's playlist. I just shared it.
It's way easier to do, like, if you have Spotify on your...
The magician is blind. Get it? The magician is blind.
I don't get it.
If you, have the PC version of Spotify, you can just set songs to repeat.
Yeah. The cartoon rabbit is called Bags Bunny. Do you get it?
Let me see. It's funnier if you make a playlist that's just all the same song.
I'll take your word for it.
Yeah, and then COD 4 came out and all video games became like COD 4. And to be clear, I love Call of Duty 4.
Got it.
Or rather, 15-year-old me loved it.
Yes.
Actually, you know what? Unironically, I think Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2, the first one, might be my favorite first-person shooter because it had that endless horde mode.
Which one? Which game were you
in? Modern Warfare 2, 2009. Not to be confused with Modern Warfare 2.
No, not the horde mode. It had the Spec Ops.
Yeah,
Spec Ops. It was Cold War that had the zombies.
I'm not talking about zombie horde mode.
Okay,
talking about Spec Ops. There was like a mode where you just picked a map and you had your guns and there was just a bunch of other dudes with guns that rushed at you. Was that Spec Ops?
Spec Ops. Maybe one of the missions is Spec Ops.
Yeah. Okay.
But those are like more mission based. Ooh, okay, so does Blade Storm. Oh, I know, that's a tactics game. Never mind.
Feel free, yeah, feel free to think of any other character action games. The line I'm going for is, does it have some level of, like, is it directly trying to do a thing?
Afro Samurai.
The very first Afro Samurai game was okay.
But is it dubious? It seems dubious.
I don't think you're allowed to talk about it.
It's just very one note. Like, there's two Afro Samurai games.
I mean, Afro Samurai 2, Revenge of Kuma, is a video game they literally took off your...
You have to go to a certain website to find it.
They literally canceled that game after it came out and then took it off everyone's hard drive and gave them refunds. Which, you know, I'm gonna say...
Oh, shit, it's bagpipes. It's one of the worst inventions ever.
That's more effort I'm willing to put in than... That's more effort than I'm willing to put in to play a game.
Yeah, that's fair enough. But yeah, the first year of the PS3 was dire.
Yeah, it turns out that the cell processor was incredibly hard to program for, and all
the documentation
Sony's promises...
Sony gave was not in English.
Yeah. Apparently, being a developer for the PS3 was not fun.
Yeah, yeah. You know, people eventually got it to work, right?
Yeah.
But it...
Yeah, eventually.
But it is one of those things where it sounds like... It was rough going.
It's an M. Peter Lorre reference.
Yeah, people love to... make references to Peter Lorre. Because he goes, hey, yes! And you're like, that's an iconic voice, let's parody it.
I mean, he was really good playing a pedophile in M.
In what?
Fritz Lang's M.
Oh.
The 1931 German Expressionist epic.
Of course.
Shit, that's hot.
I'm not doing a joke. That's an actual movie. You can watch it.
Yeah.
You should watch it.
Okay.
It's one of the greatest movies ever.
I'm going to need...
Ooh, here's a question. Does Overlord count as a character action game? Or is it more like a squad fantasy?
I mean, it's kind of a character action game, and it's kind of Pikmin, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Overlord's weird. It's like somewhere between, like, an action role-playing game and Pikmin.
Yeah.
I'm not entirely sure what I'd call Pikmin.
But like, it is dubious.
They made two of them.
It's pretty dubious. They made two of them, the second one's even more dubious.
Do you know what's a game from the 360 that I remember playing a lot of, and even as a kid being like, this sucks shit. Why
were there
am I
any
playing?
Game?
No, The Outfit era. By Relic.
Yeah.
Not one of Relic's best games.
No, not at all.
The... We have Company of Heroes on a controller at home game. Golden Axe Beast Rider, you're right. I've seen copies of that game for not that much money and thought about buying them. Thank God I'm broke.
Oh, what game are you streaming, Mr. Arbitrary Water?
I'm playing Shadow Man.
The Shadow Man.
Elaborate on
that. Yeah, what was the now that we're talking about the outfit and kind of like that weird era where like there were more World War II games than any other war game ever. What was the one that was inspired by Band of Brothers and had like weird tactical shit?
Brothers in Arms.
Oh, Brothers in Arms. See, the 360 one of those is actually a good game.
Randy Pitchford's Brothers in Arms.
Right.
Like the last one they made was good.
But yeah, Harley, I was playing Shadow of War Door. And the joke was going to be if I died, then I was going to play a different game with the word Shadow in the title. And instead of playing Shadow the Hedgehog, I started playing Shadow Man. That's the joke.
Which is the obviously superior game, the Shadow Man.
This is a better game than Shadow the Hedgehog, I'm willing to say.
That's so brave.
Oh, I'm gonna disagree. I've seen nothing about this game.
I mean, Harley, have you watched any of M playing Shadow the Hedgehog?
Why would I need to watch M play a game that I've played to 100% multiple times?
Hell yeah, you have.
Absolute sicko shit.
I'm sorry, I'm built different.
Hey, I 100%ed that game when I was, or I got the true ending in that game.
Booty. I don't like this guy's head, the size of it. It feels like it should break his entire body.
Damn, you touched that red water and it just killed you. Like, I get it's probably supposed to be lava, but also, damn.
See, now I'm at the point where I'm like, I wonder if I'm not supposed to be here yet. If I need something that I don't have. But it's to my great displeasure to announce that Shadow Man seems totally decent for what it is.
Are you like a zombie or something?
This is based on a comic book, an indie label comic book from the 90s.
Okay, right, because they made video games out of anything back then.
Yeah. So, Shadow Man, I'm a guy who has inherited the power of the Shadow Man. I'm from New Orleans. And I can go into the realm of the dead and use voodoo guns. Okay. And also cuss. Because this ain't your daddy's N64 game. Or maybe right. It is.
So, like, how are you supposed to make this jump?
You just do
that. Oh, hold it. Someone's scratching at the door, and I think I know who it is.
Is it a Doge? Doge?
It's not. I just hallucinated.
Who was scratching?
Hallucinated.
He's scratching.
Who is tapping at my chamber door? Quoth the raven, nevermore.
I teach Fagrab Poe.
Yeah, you do.
Oh, yeah, the carpenter's here to talk to you about the union. You paying your dues, or you a scab? I only do the work the union permits you to let me do. Hey, when I ask you to kick up to my boss, kick up to my boss, all right? Unless you want this tire and straight up your ass.
Yeah. But I think the character action thing is the thing I'm going to do after I'm done with this. I was thinking maybe the Wheel of Dubious RPGs 3, but I want to...
Aha! Puns!
I want to see Yaiba Ninja Gaiden Z. Terrible place.
Ah. Shit on the floor. Why did you shit on the floor?
Got it.
I'm just happy to hear that, regardless of context. Because I assume it's for Torn's passage is just a delightful pass.
Over here.
Hey.
Oh, the carpenter's gone. Now I'm gonna steal his saw. Because I saw it.
The Dark Souls.
I saw a Cybertruck again.
I'm sorry. Night Dive's commitment to doing the best work with the most mid stuff is commendable. Yeah. I will happily play that Turok 3 port they made when it's on sale. Cuz I ain't paying $30 for that game.
I've been thinking about playing that Colossal Cave game, but I ain't paying that amount of money for a remaster of Colossal Cave Adventure.
You know,
have you
Night Dive did,
Oh. What was the reception on that, remake remaster of Wizardry? Was it good?
It seems mostly positive. I thought Power Slave was pretty good. That's my general. And they're doing Dark Forces later this year.
Oh, that sounds fun.
Just in time for the 30th anniversary. Meanwhile, still no solid date on the System Shock 2 remaster. Oh, now you have me disoriented.
Look at the saw. The puzzle here is to keep talking to her until she lets me go on. can go on the stage now. Alright, here's some classic fucking Sierra music.
So System Shock 3, at least what the version of that game made by Other Side was canned a couple years ago. And I guess Tencent ostensibly has the rights to make a new System Shock game called System Shock 3 if they want. We're gonna save here. And that'll be it for me with Shadowman. Oh, that's right there. Oh, listen, all of the good weapon, all of the good video games are have been remastered. All
right. Oh, this game, huh? I have 833 points.
Have you won the Torrance Passage yet?
No, because I had there was a really hard labyrinth puzzle.
Well, I'm going to raid you.
And that's why I appreciate you and the person that you are.
Thanks, everyone, for watching. That was about 40 minutes of Shadow of Wardor. And then almost 2 hours of Shadow Man Remastered. So take of that what you will.
My blanket. I think I'm close to the end here.